नमस्कार, वी विल स्टार्ट विथ जनरल फीचर्स ऑफ ए रिब। इन दिस वी विल कवर टुडे टिपिकल एंड अटिपिकल रिब्स विथ इट्स फीचर्स। टिपिकल रिब्स, दिस वन इज टिपिकल रिब। यू कैन सी हियर दिस टिपिकल रिब एंड इट इज लॉन्ग, लेंथी एंड इट्स पार्ट्स आर इट इज लाइक दिस एंड इन दिस। दिस इज posterior end or vertebral end, this one is anterior end or sternal end. In between these two there is presence of shaft. Now here this is posterior end. In posterior end parts, which parts present in posterior end? This one is head, now this one is neck, this one is tubercles. Now there are two tubercles. In this head there is presence of, you can see, articular facet. Now in this articular facet there is a small crest in between these two upper and lower articular facet. This lower articular facet articulate with respective vertebra, upper facet articulates with this upper vertebra. Now in between these two there is crest. From head there is, it will, this one is neck. This neck will go, you can see here, this neck will go posterolaterally. This neck will show anterior surface, posterior surface, upper and lower borders. Just lateral to this neck there is presence of tubercles. In these tubercles you can see here, this one is articular and this is upper is non-articular part. These two tubercles, or you can say tubercles, this articulate tubercle articulates with transverse process, one facet present on transverse process of that respective vertebra. Upper is non-articular part of that tubercle. Here in relation with this neck you can see this is anterior surface of this, and this anterior surface, in relation with this anterior surface, this anterior surface, now it is lower border, continue laterally. You can see this one is lower border of this neck and it will continue laterally with upper margin of costal groove. This costal groove is present in shaft of rib. Here in relation with this neck posterior aspect there is a presence of one oblique line. This one is oblique line, this one is oblique line in relation with this posterior aspect, just lateral to this tubercle. This oblique line, this is for attachment of some muscles and some structures. We have already covered this in lecture. This one, this is shaft. Now in this shaft it is a flat long bone, and in relation with this shaft it shows an angle. This one is posterior angle in relation with this shaft. This shaft shows upper border, lower border, outer surface and inner surface. Then this upper border, lower border, outer surface, inner surface, this lower border, now in relation with this lower border there is presence of costal groove. You can see there is a prominent groove in relation with lower border of this shaft. And this costal groove, it shows two lips, upper and lower. This upper lip of this costal groove forms lower boundary of neck, and lower boundary of this costal groove, it will form this lower sharp margin of this lower part of this rib, or lower margin, lower border of this rib. Then we'll come to anterior end of rib. This one is anterior end of rib, and in this there is presence of one concave facet. You can see here there is presence of one concave facet, and this facet articulates with its respective costal cartilage. In relation with this There is again presence of one oblique line. You can see here there is one oblique line. This is for attachment of some muscles. It will limit attachment of some muscles. We already covered in lecture part. And this is about typical rib. Now next is atypical rib. In atypical rib, first, second, 10, 11 and 12. This one is atypical rib. In this atypical rib, this is first number. Now it is a flat, small, length is very less. Now its features: head, neck, tubercle. This one is anterior end. Now head shows single round facet for articulation with first thoracic vertebra, body of first thoracic vertebra. Neck goes laterally and backward. This is tubercle. This tubercle articulates with this costal facet present on transverse process of first thoracic vertebra. Now this rib, what is difference here? It shows two surfaces, upper surface and lower surface, inner border and outer border. Now this one is upper surface. In relation with this upper surface, there is presence of grooves, this one and this one, anterior groove and posterior groove. In relation with this groove, now this groove, in relation with this groove, there is presence of one sharp elevated tubercle, and this is Kalaney tubercle. In relation with this inner margin, inner border of first rib. Now these grooves will give passage for vessels anteriorly and posteriorly, and in between these two there is presence of Kalaney tubercle. It will give attachment to which muscle? Scalenus anterior. And here there is again, in relation with this outer border, there is presence of one elevated part, and it will show attachment of first digitation of serratus anterior muscle. This one is anterior end, and it will show again depressed part, concave facet for articulation with first costal cartilage. Now side identification of this first rib. This is a flat rib. If you put down both end, anterior and posterior end will touch to the surface, means side of that rib is right. But if what happens, posterior end and elevated, then this anatomical position is not right. Therefore, for side identification of this atypical rib, place that first rib on a flat surface, and when both end, anterior and posterior end, touches to this surface, it indicates side of that rib, right or left. This is about first rib. Now next rib, second rib. This one is second rib. You can compare, this rib is double the length of first rib, and in this rib, head, neck, tubercle, you can see surfaces of shaft, outer and inner surface. Outer surface faces outward and upward, while inner surface faces downward and medially. This is about these surfaces. In relation with this outer surface, there is presence of one tubercle, and it will give attachment to second digitation of serratus anterior muscle. This is second atypical rib. After that, 10th, 11th and 12th. 10th rib, again it looks like this, but actually this one is 11th rib. 10th rib, what is present there? It is same like this, length is short, all things, head, neck, tubercle present, and length is short. Then this is 11th rib. It is a small rib. In this rib, head, neck, here what you can see here, there is no tubercle, but in lower aspect there is presence of costal groove, a small costal groove in relation with only posterior part, posterior two-third part of this rib, 11th rib. And this one is anterior end of this 11th rib. Now, last one is 12th rib or typical rib. You can see here, this one is flat rib, very small. It shows head, then shaft, no neck, no tubercle, no costal groove, but surfaces. Now it will show anterior surface and posterior surface. You can see here, anterior surface, posterior surface, upper border and lower border. This is about general features of these typical and atypical ribs.